When Braque met Picasso. 2 years after Albert Einstein first brought us his theory of special relativity and forever shattered the way we view the universe, Pablo Picasso and Georges Braque did the same for art. Really, for art. They threw away the old ways of viewing art and deconstructed art as a new discipline, thus creating modern art. Wow. Cubism and other forms of the modern art went back to the first principle of the shape and form and denuded a subject of its unnecessary details, leaving the very basic elements of a figure. Yes, this is what the abstract is, right? To generalize things and to give you more freedom with respect to the essential structures. Like Einstein, they concentrated on the relationship among the elements of the subject as a space and time related to the speed of light in the relativity theory, creating a new art form. Wow! There were mathematical and philosophical ideas at play in both the new physics and the new art. Braque's Fermi à la guitare, 1913, Centre Georges Pompidou, Paris, demonstrates this break with the past in a painting and emphasis on the simplest visual elements and their structure and the interrelations among them. Wow. This is the time when the Art Deco was introduced, after the Art Nouveau, right? But Cubism was born five years before this painting was made, when in 1907 Picasso created Le Demoiselle d'Avignon, the first Cubist painting. This picture broke the mold and exhibited the beginning of the destruction of the old and the restructuring of the new to begin a new age in the painting, one that would eventually strip away form and redefine structure. Yes. Picasso's African period, 1907 to 1909, saw him go back to the primitive tribal art to seek the new elements of the space he wanted to introduce into the art after discarding the old realist way of painting. This was one stage in the development of the world's most unusual artist, and it would lead to the invention of the Cubism by Picasso and Braque. Huh. So cool, so interesting. Pablo Picasso was born in Malaga, Spain, in 1881, the son of an art teacher. From an early age, he showed a great ability and interest in drawing. He was exposed to the traditional forms of the art, but as he grew older, he embraced the modernista movement in Catalonia, right? Picasso studied in art academies in Coruña, Barcelona, and Madrid, and became disaffected with academic art. He moved to Barcelona as a young man and pursued the study of painting that was influenced by the French avant-garde movements. These young artists emulated the style depicted in the art of the Toulouse-Lautrec and pursued the life of the anarchist and bohemians. Right. In 1900, 19-year-old Picasso visited Paris, the city he had lodged for as a teenager, where he visited the Universal Exposition, and and was charmed beyond their words by the French capital. Yes, this is what Paris is, right? All right. After his return to Barcelona, he vowed that he would find a way to move to Paris. He realized this dream the following year when he came back to Paris to work on his first major exhibition, arranged by Ambroise Vollard, who had set up Cézanne's important exhibition of 1898. Picasso's exhibition was fabulously successful, although some accused the young Spanish painter of imitating known artists such as Toulouse Lautrec. In part because of this criticism, Picasso changed the track. He dropped his vivid colors and instead chose a somber blue palette, which inaugurated his now famous blue period. Ah, this would later be transformed into the browns, tans, and grays of the monochrome phase of the Cubism. Right. Wow. The evolution, right? Picasso began selling his painting with much success. Drawn to the dramatic and symbolic topics for his paintings in his blue period, he created major works that depicted love, desire, birth, and death. Georges Braque was born on May 13, 1882, in Argenteuil-Seine, France. He grew up in the Le Havre and studied at the local École des Beaux-Arts until 1899. Then he left for Paris to study under a master decorator and received his craftsman certificate in 1901. From 1902 to 1904, Braque worked as a painter at the Académie Hubert in Paris, and by 1906, his work, which had been associated with Impressionism, was no longer in that tradition, and he adopted the Fauve style. Braque spent the summer of 1906 in Antwerp with Orson Fries, and when he returned to Paris at the end of the summer, he exhibited his Fauve paintings at the Salon de l'Independence. I'm sorry, my French. Braque was interested in the painting techniques and pictorial order that were studied by Cézanne. Picasso, however, was not interested in Cézanne, but was rather influenced by the exotic imagery of the Gauguin, whom he emulated in his painting during this period. Right, there is a tradition, there is a context. There is a context that genius was born. Okay. Picasso settled in Paris in 1904 and became the center of a social circle named after him, Le Bande à Picasso. Braque and Picasso inevitably became interlinked through their relationship to the Matisse. Braque had almost become an apprentice of the Matisse and was greatly influenced by his work, while Picasso saw Matisse as a rival. Oh, I see. Picasso and Matisse met at the Salon de l'Independence in 1906 and competed with each other to become a king of the moderns. Yes. The two young artists, Picasso and Braque, lived and worked within the same modernist circle in Paris. Sometime in 1907, Braque left too, calling cards for Picasso. He scribbled regards on one and anticipated memories on the other. Picasso's sketchbook in the early 1907 contains the entries "Light to black," followed by sometimes in April 1907, Black Friday. Later that year, the poet Guillaume Apollinaire accompanied Black to the Picasso's studio to see a new and unprecedented painting. Five nude women drawn in the proto-cubist style, Le Demoiselles d'Avignon. There followed a period of intense work for them both, during the which Braque and Picasso further developed cubism, working as a friend and as friendly competitors. From 1909, Picasso and Braque entered a later period in which they developed cubism in a new direction, and by 1911, their styles, up to that time directly different, became extremely similar. So they reached the universal form, right? As if it is a numerical formula of something, of some laws. In 1912, the two artists started to incorporate colleague elements into their painting and so experiments with their pasted paper technique. Their collaboration continued until World War I broke out in 1914, when Braque joined the French army. He was wounded in a battle, and upon his recovery in 1917, he began a close relationship with Johann Gris. Right. The path of Braque and Picasso then diverged. The revolution in art brought about by Braque and Picasso was stamped up as follows. Let each person proclaim, here is a great native work of the destruction to be accomplished. This exhortation, made in the Date Manifesto 1918, led by Tristan Tzara on March 23, 1918 in Zurich, gives a good idea of the atmosphere preceding over modernity's beginnings. Destroy the old world in order to reconstruct a new, modern world. Depose the old mankind in order to move towards a new one. Dismantle the academy in order to institute a new state of mind. Such was the program proposed by the modern art, a program that placed the idea of the destruction at the very heart of the definition of the art. And this redefinition has continued to be effective throughout the centuries.